hectic.
Yeah.
7 day weeks, 12, 14 hour days.
Wow.
But I didn't look upon it as work.
Right.
I felt that I was being paid to indulge my hobby, which was racing cars, and so I didn't mind working the hours. Well, it was completed within 4 months of starting, all by hand, because there was no computer technology then, no CAD. Although there was drawing office staff, I always did all the work and all the drawings myself, so I didn't actually have people working for me. That way, if there was a mistake, I could only blame myself.
Yes.
Colin at the time was over in Australia and New Zealand supervising the Tasman Series entries, and by that time he'd sort of got enough faith in me to give me carte blanche.
Yeah.
But he was still surprised when he came back and saw what I'd done.
Traveling in bursts of over 190 miles per hour, Jimmy Clark burns up the straightaway like a football quarterback on an end run.
At Indy, the cars just go one way round,
and the
circuit is very slightly banked. You know, it's not a steep bank, and it's only about 10 degrees. And it was not to do with the handling; it was to try to lessen the tyre wear on the outside tyre. That was the main reason for it. Well, I always felt that with every car I designed.
Yeah.
Self-confidence, I suppose you could call it, or big-headedness, either way.
Still holding his record-breaking pace, Jimmy Clark crosses the finish line to become the victor of the 1965 Indianapolis 500.
Oh, marvellous. Really was. So, yeah, no complaints whatsoever. Even though Colin and I didn't get on very well socially, as a design team, we worked very, very well together. I think I was the only person on the design side that he was prepared to listen to on occasions.